channel. Today's video is about skincare. As you guys know, I love skincare so much. It's so important to me. And one thing that happened to me when I moved to Brazil was that my skincare routine got really bad, especially because I didn't know most of the products they sell here. I just kind of like lost it because my skin got a lot better with birth control, and so I kind of forgot that I really had to take care of it. But luckily, I'm back now, everything is fine, I'm taking care of my skin, and actually, to be honest, it's looking really bad right now. I have a few breakouts, but let's just pretend they're not here, that they don't exist. Some of the products that I'm gonna be showing you are vegan and cruelty-free, and that is something that is very important to me. I don't know if you guys know that, but I used to be a vegetarian. The reason why I am not anymore is because after this really hard breakup that I had like half a year ago, I'm not sure, almost a year ago now, but after that breakup, I was like, I want to do what I want to do. I want to think of, like, I just want to be a little selfish because I always thought of other people first. I always wanted them to feel good and them to feel nice. And I know it's kind of selfish for me to say that, oh, like, I'm just gonna eat an animal when an animal has no fault in what happened. But I hope you guys understand what I'm saying. It basically was like therapy for me, like just knowing how to love myself and like doing whatever I want to do without caring about what people think of me. I do avoid lots of meat still, and like I know that milk is bad for you and stuff, and that is why I really appreciate when products are cruelty free and vegan. Also because sometimes there are really bad things in products that you don't know, that are very like artificial, and that can be really bad for your skin actually. So there is this really nice brand called Ecoten from Australia, and I've never been there. I really want to go there someday. All of the products are made in Australia and vegan and cruelty-free and organic. The only thing that does not say cruelty-free is their self-tanner, but I'm pretty sure it is cruelty-free. It's organic and vegan, and if it's vegan, it's most likely also cruelty-free. But first, when it comes to removing my makeup, one thing that I started doing that I really love, that is organic and cruelty-free, of course, is using coconut oil. I know that some of you may be like, oh my god, I'm gonna break out and blah blah blah, and trust me guys, I have the most sensitive skin on earth. Like, everything and anything gives me pimples or an infection, or it just hurts, like it's annoying. Trust me, it's really annoying. But one thing that I started doing that I really love is using coconut oil. Just melts off all the makeup. It is a cheaper version for me because the Clinique balm here is really expensive. It's not like in Switzerland. Switzerland was pretty cheap. Like, I know that like money is different in each country. What you earn is not the same amount as in Switzerland, and things here are more expensive, and in Switzerland they're cheaper. I don't know if you understand, but I'm pretty sure you did. So I just reached out for coconut oil. My mom bought this actually for my sister for her hair. I love using coconut oil for my hair. My hair has grown so much actually, also because of coconut oil. Coconut oil has always been my favorite thing. So I just take a little bit of this, rub it through my hand just to warm it up a little bit, put it on my face, melt off all the eye makeup. I especially love using this for eye makeup, it's really good. And then I just move on to cleanser. So now let's talk about this brand called Eco by Sonia Driver. They reached out to me and they sent me a few products, and I was really happy to try them out because, as I said, I have very sensitive skin, and vegan and organic products are just what works best for my skin. That's the case most of the time. As you can tell, I've used lots of it. It's already down here. I really like this. It smells like lemons, and I love the packaging. I love this like wood detail right here. I don't know if you guys can tell. So the lid here looks like fig wood. It's really pretty. Pretty bottles can make such a difference when you're like using the product or also in your bathroom. It looks really cute. So this says that it's meant for all skin types. It has aloe vera in it, lemongrass, and caviar lime. For super clean skin without harshness, face, neck, and beyond. And it also tells you to apply 1 to 2 pumps morning and night to face, neck, and beyond. To wash off with warm water and repeat if necessary. there's also the scrub that they sent me, which is an acai scrub, and it actually tells you that it's number 2 and this one is number 1. So you're supposed to use this first, then this one, and you should be fine. One thing is that I like using this, then this, and then this one again, because I feel like this scrub leaves like a little residue on your face, not a bad one. Because of my sensitive skin, I prefer just like getting rid of it and just using this as a regular scrub. I really like this. It's really gentle to the skin and gets rid of all the dirt on your face. I also like using a little brush to help. And yeah, as you can tell, I really like it. Almost empty. So now guys, let's talk about the scrub. As I said, this is a super acai exfoliator. It's for the face, but you can also use it for your neck and your body and whatever you want to use it for. So this is meant for all skin types. It has acai, coconut and magnesium salts in it. This is very salty. Like once I was scrubbing my face and I accidentally tasted it and it was salty, guys. But this is a very harsh exfoliator. This is not a gentle one. I like that. I prefer having something that actually gets rid of all the dead skin on my face and my body. And the directions tell you to apply on clean and dry skin on face, neck and beyond, once or twice a week, massage it in circular motion. As I said, I like using it on wet skin. I don't know, like it's up to you, but I prefer using this on wet skin. I don't really like using scrubs on dry skin, but it's totally your choice of what you want to do. I really like this one. I also like the smell of it. It smells really nice and the color is blue. It's a blue scrub. I have never seen an acai exfoliator before, like any acai products for your skin, and that is why I was really impressed. But this one I really like. As I said, it is vegan and cruelty free and you don't have to worry about hurting any animals while using it. So after washing my face and doing everything that I have to do, I like using a toner. This one is by Catherine Hill. This is a Brazilian brand and it smells really good. Gets rid of all the oils on your face and all the grease and everything and all the makeup that is left over on your face even after washing it. Another thing that I want to tell you is that sometimes I do wash my face on a sink, but most of the time I like doing that in the shower because I feel like it just gets rid of all the things on your face. Like you don't have to worry about having makeup left over because in the shower you usually wash off everything. Really helped me with my skin. I also like using this on clients. It's really good. Like before doing their makeup, it's amazing. And after that, I like using this moisturizer right here. I have always been the type of person who was very against using moisturizers on my face because I thought that I would break out and look like whatever pimple monster you want to call me. But this one is really nice. The girl who did my eyebrows told me about this actually, and this is the La Roche-Posay. It's called Effaclar. I don't know, like I would just put the name down below in the description box. But this one is really nice for your face because it's not greasy at all. It feels really nice on the skin and it also smells like very refreshing. It smells really good. I love the smell of the product. So good. So this is the moisturizer that I use. It's really good. It's good for sensitive skin and it does the job. Like, use a moisturizer, guys. It's really important. You don't want to have wrinkles. It's really important to take care of your face. Even if you have oily skin, just get a moisturizer which is meant for your skin type and you won't have to worry about anything. So this is basically all I do for the face part. Now I want to talk about this self-tanner. So this is the EcoTan self-tanner, the Cocoa Firming Mousse. And this is a 1 hour self-tan for all skin types. So this brand only has organic and natural ingredients. So this product is also organic and vegan. It tells you to exfoliate your skin before doing this, to apply it evenly on clean dry skin, and to wash your hands fully after application. I was really scared when I read this. Usually when you use a self-tanner, you're supposed to use like this mitt that you use for applying it, so your hands won't be yellow and like filled with self-tanner. But this one is actually meant for you to use on your hands. And I did that, I tried it out for you guys. It actually works, guys. Like, I washed my hands afterward, dried it, I was really careful, and my hands were not yellow. They were actually like just a little tiny bit down here because I did not wash them like really good, but they were not yellow. The thing about the self-tanner is that it's really lightweight and it delivers this beautiful skin color. I don't know how to explain it, but it's not like dramatic tan boom. You can leave this for 1 hour on your skin for you to look just a little bit tanner like me right now. I actually applied it a few days ago and it looks like this right now. It's still a little bit on my skin. So you can leave this product on for 1 hour as it says, but you can leave it also for 4 hours if you want a deeper tan on your skin. This is like a very careful product. It's not the product that will immediately like change everything like boom there you go. No, it's really, if you want to try out a self tanner, if you've never used one before, I really recommend this because it's not as dramatic as other ones. It's really good because you can see a difference and it still looks very natural, if you know what I'm saying. It also says that after showering, a light color will appear, but the tan will continue to develop for up to 48 hours. And that is also something that I noticed. After showering, I was like, oh, it looks really pretty and stuff. And then when I woke up the next morning, I was like, oh, I look a little bit darker. And that is because it develops. It is true, like, you will look a little bit darker than right after the shower when you just applied it. It's also something that I really like because it gives you time to, like, get used to the color that you just applied on your skin. Another point that I really like about this is that you can use it for your face. I did use it for my face, and one thing that I noticed, I know it's really weird, but it helped me with my acne. It kind of like cleared my skin. It was really funny, but it helped, and your skin won't look patchy, won't look too dark. It's just gonna look a little tanned, as if you just tanned a little bit in the sun. It's gonna look very natural and really pretty. So yes, of course, it does smell a little bit like regular self-tanner, but it does have this really nice lemon scent to it, which I really appreciate because self-tanners can smell really nasty sometimes, especially after like a few hours on your skin. They get to smell like, in Switzerland there is this bread called Brezel, and it smells like Brezel. Your skin will smell like pretzels. Basically, it's really weird. Oh, another product that I wanted to show to you guys really quickly is a mask that I have been using on my face that I really like. This is the Kiehl's Calendula and Aloe. This is a hydrating mask for my skin, and I was really scared to try this, guys, because I was like, oh my god, hydrating stuff is gonna give me pimples, and the girl there was like, no, it's not gonna give you pimples. I bought this in Spain, and I really love this. It's meant for all skin types, and it has aloe vera in it and calendula. It's really lightweight, and you're only supposed to leave this on your skin for like 5 minutes, I think. Yeah, for 5 minutes, and then wash it off. And it smells so good. It feels so nice. Oh, as you can tell, it smells really nice. It smells so natural. I love natural smelling things for my face. This was really nice. I like this. So guys, this was my updated skincare routine. I hope you enjoyed. Also, don't forget to check out Eco's website. I will put their link down below in the description box. And if you liked any product, you can ask me a question down below as well. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and to subscribe, and also to turn on your notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. And I hope you guys enjoyed. So I will see you guys next time and have a beautiful day. Also, guys, if you know any good product for really sensitive skin, you can let me know down below as well, because I really love trying out new stuff. So I'll see you guys next time, and see ya. Bye. You got a fetish for my love.